Last we spoke, it seemed we would never speak again. I sang from the other side as I appeared to fade into mystery, into the afterlife. My bones buried, remains embalmed, my eyes shut. But as Einstein had said, energy cannot be created, nor can it be destroyed. Our energy never dies. Therefore, the power I have will never wither, though my vessel may. I learned to hold my breath. I taught this to myself because I realize how hard it is to take another. I realize that there isn't always a chance to take another. So when my soul goes swimming, it feels safe to stay down for hours, for days, perhaps until death takes me again. But not only had I grown immune to the human need for oxygen, I had grown gills. I was born March 20th, the last day of the zodiac, Pisces. Its representative symbol depicts two fish circling around, tailing the other. I often identify more with the image itself than what the image stands for. I am obsessively swimming around and around, chasing something I will never again have the pleasure of biting. I must learn to break the circle, run from the circle, and leave. I must let go, not only to release me, but to release the other. Holding something captive, whether it be in physical chains and behind physical bars, or inside an emotional jail cell of sorts, will not elicit love from the subject that is being held in that captivity. It's catch and release, to and fro, grabbing hold and letting go. Because there's no way I could ever reach you. You're meant for the moon. And I cannot just wait here forever in the foam of the tide, waiting for you to come back in. Sometimes I find that I have difficulty deciphering what I am in this. Am I the fish or the fisherman? Moby Dick or Captain Ahab? The flesh or the spear that pierces it? I am both, I've found. I've also found that as cliche as it sounds, there are lots of fish in the sea. We are all the same, just wearing different smiles and different clothes and different colors. Love can be found in any single one of us. So really, love means both everything and nothing. I must let go of you. I must let go of who I was, who I thought I would be. I must let go of what I had, what I wanted. I must let go and keep going, because there's no way that I could keep you. Not even with my